Hey there, YouTube. So I'm down here in my studio. I was trying to make a recording, and I'm listening to myself through the headphones, and my instrument sounds a little bit like a sewing machine. Because we're all used to the sound of, the keys when we play our instruments. These are fairly large keys and rods. They're going to make noise, right? You can't do anything about that. This is the sound of the pads closing onto the wood, right? That's just the way the instrument sounds. But what you're not hearing and what you don't want to hear is the sound of metal clanking on metal, because that is a very different sound. I realized as I was playing this G to G sharp trill, and I'm recording myself, that I've got a metal on metal problem. Here, let me show you what I mean. That is not a sound I want. I want it to sound a little bit more like that. This is a kind of maintenance that you can easily take care of yourself. There's a lot that I will recommend you not do on the bass clarinet, but when you have an issue like this, it's pretty easy to solve, and it's certainly a lot cheaper than going to a repair person and doing it. So let me just show you what I'm going to do. First of all, I have to diagnose where the clicking is coming from, and then I have to figure out what I'm going to do to stop it from clicking. And the third thing I'm going to do is do that thing. So let's get started. Okay, so because the problem is on this G sharp key and it's localized here, this is a very simple mechanism, it's going to be really easy to diagnose this problem. Let's take a quick look at how the G sharp key works. All right, it's very simple. You push this down here, this key here, and it pivots against this rod and it opens up this pad right here. Right. Okay, so where could this click be coming from? When you press it down, you're hearing it when you press it, but not when you're letting it go. Great. So we know that the issue is when you're pressing it. Sometimes the issue actually comes from when you're releasing it. This one is not that case. This rod itself is okay. This pivot is fine. But let's flip this around here and take a look. Oh, whoa. Okay, so we've got this post down here that's drilled into the wood that stops this key from going any further, right? And this is metal, and this is metal. Now, there probably was some cork up here before. That cork, the glue may have come loose or somehow may have gotten scraped off. So now that there's no cork between these two things, it creates a clicking sound. All right, so simple enough. We figured out that we need to stick something in between that post and that key. You could use a lot of different things, right? You could use neoprene, you could use Teflon, you could use a bunch of stuff. I'm just going to use some plain old-fashioned good old cork. Now, you can buy cork in different thicknesses, and it's important that you use the right thickness when you solve this problem, and I'll explain that why in a second. But first off, here's where you can go and buy some cork. Pick up some of the cork in different thicknesses, and you can pick up some glue, maybe a screwdriver set and a knife or whatever, and you'll have a little kit of stuff to solve this problem whenever this problem arises, okay? And because this is a fairly easy thing to solve, I'm going to show you how to do it. So we've decided we're going to use cork. Now it's time to decide what thickness we use. I've got a thick piece and I have a thin piece here. Well, why does it even matter? Here's the thing. The way the instrument works and the way pads work is that when the pad is open, if it's open too far, that means that note is going to be sharp. And in fact, this G sharp, because there's nothing in here, it's opening the pad too far. That note is going to be sharp. So what I need to do and what's going to happen is when I stick a piece of cork in there, then pad isn't going to open as far, right? Because the key itself is going to stop and hit the cork before it goes all the way down to that metal. That's the point of it. But if I use a piece of cork that's too thin, it's still going to be sharp. If I use a piece of cork that's too thick, it's going to be flat. So you want the cork to be the right thickness. Now, if you have a piece of cork that's too thick and the note is flat, you can always take a little bit of sandpaper and sand it down. That's probably what I'm going to wind up doing, but let me show you the difference. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tune that G, half step below it. Now, if that note is in tune, I want to see how sharp the G sharp is when I play it. So let's get the G in tune. This is a strobe. When that strobe stops moving, the note is in tune. Now, if I play the G sharp, it's going to move upward. It's going to sort of scroll up, which means that that note is too sharp. So what we need, and we knew that it was going to be the case, is let's actually put in the thin piece of cork, because I always want to use the thinnest piece I can, use. I don't know why, but it just, less cork, maybe it's cheaper, I don't know. All right, so what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to see if actually this thin piece of cork will stop the real problem that I'm trying to solve, which is the clicking. It does. You can still hear the key, but you're not hearing that loud click. All right, so when I stick that cork in, I'm not gluing it, obviously, I'm just going to stick it in and I'm going to hold it. I'm going to see if that G sharp now is in tune. If it still moves, scrolls up, that means the cork is too thin, I'm going to have to use the thicker piece. And in fact, that's the case. So this cork is too thin. It means the key is opening too far. We need a thicker piece to keep the key from opening. Fortunately, I have one. That looks looks like it's going to be the winner. Now, it could even be thicker than this, but this is the thickest piece I have, so this is the piece I'm going to use. So I've decided I'm going with the thicker piece, not the thinner, because that keeps the pad from opening as far, and it obviously solves my issue of the clicking sound. Let me show you now how you actually install this piece of cork onto the either the key itself or to the post. All right? Okay, so here we are at my workbench. I have the top joint of the bass clarinet sitting on this towel here to cushion it because the bench itself is made out of wood. And I've got my piece of cork, I've got a screwdriver, I've got pliers, and I've got a blade here. And first thing that we need to do is we need to remove this key, the G-sharp key. I'm just going to unscrew it, and then I'm going to pull out this screw straight out with the pliers. You're probably not going to want to use your fingers for a couple reasons. You want to pull it straight out, and also the rod itself is going to have some grease on it, and you don't necessarily want that all over your fingers as you're working on the instrument. Come on. There we go. All right, I'm going to put this over here so I don't lose it, and I'm going to take the key off, being very careful to not bend or break this spring right there. And it's also very, very sharp, so you have to be careful with that. So now that I have the key off, I'm going to take a look at the post, which is right here, and indeed there is no cork on it. That's why it's making the clicking sound when these two things touch. Now that I have the key off, I have to decide whether I want to put the cork onto the key or onto the post. And I've decided I'm going to put it onto the post because it's going to use less cork. And then what I've done is I've cut myself with my handy dandy razor blade a tiny square of cork that will fit right onto the post itself. And then once the cement has dried, I'll just carve off those four little corners and I'll be good to go. What I'm going to use to as an adhesive is I'm going to use contact cement. Now you could use Elmer's glue, but I really don't recommend it. Contact cement is the best stuff to use. The thing about contact cement though is you need to use it in a room that has some airflow because this stuff is really, really stinky. So you want to make sure that it's well ventilated. And the way it works is you put the contact cement, a little bit of it on to one of the surfaces, the cork, and a little bit onto the post, and you let it dry for about 10 minutes. And then when you put the two of them together, they are cemented into place. Now, obviously, I only need to use a tiny little bit of this cement. Okay, so there's a really little thin film of it, and then a little thin film of it onto the cork. There it goes. And now I'm just going to set this down to dry for about 10 or 15 minutes. Oh my god, it's really sticky. There we go. And you let them dry separately. Okay, I give up. I'm just going to let you sit there. See you in a minute. Okay, so it's been about 10, 15 minutes, and the cement has dried. And all I have to do now is marry these two together. But you only get one shot, so I want to make sure that I have it lined up properly. There we go. And once it's on, it is on. So make sure that you got it in the right place. Now that it's on there, I'm just going to simply shave off. It doesn't have to really look perfect because, frankly, you're not going to be able to see it, but I'm going to shave off. And now I'm just going to take the key, and I'm going to, if you can see this, what I have to be careful of is I want to make sure that the spring sits underneath the spring catch right here. So I'm going to sort of lean it like that underneath it and push up and into place so that the rod is between the two posts. And I'm going to get my screw, and I'm going to stick it part of the way in. And I'm going to put a little dab of key oil on it before I push it the rest of the way. All right, there we go. And now I just have to screw it back in. Wipe off the excess oil, and let's see. Ha ha! No more clicking. Looks like crap, but doesn't sound like it. All right, so there you go. If you're better at this than I am, it'll look nice. But sometimes function is more important than form. And in this case, that's one of those times. So, all right. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope this was helpful. See you next time. Bye.